Hey guys! Hello, my brat prince and princesses. It's the ring queen, Lexa Rose, in my Star Wars best. Wearing my limited edition, exclusively made for me, Roddy Piper memorial shirt that was made specifically for me by a friend of mine who is a clothing designer. He goes by the name of Solomon Reese. He has a smokers only clothing line. When Roddy Piper passed away, he's a huge wrestling fan. So when Roddy Piper passed away, he made this really amazing shirt, which is the one I'm wearing right now. And I liked it a lot. And I was like, dude, I like this shirt, but is there any way you can make it a tank top? So for me, he did. He made it a tank top. So just to show you guys, his links will be down below, as well as his website where you can buy, you know, gear like this. If you want like custom made stuff like this, like what I have, like my tank top, you just hit him up and he will work with you. He's, you know, his prices are a little expensive, but it's so worth it because the quality is great. I mean, I've had this shirt for more than a year, and as you can see, it's still bright and vibrant and red as ever, and it's really, really comfortable. So his links are down below, his Facebook and his store website. Just click the links or whatever and tell them that Lexa Rose sent you. He's a really good friend of mine. Me and Solomon actually known each other since high school. So, you know, me being an athlete and a wrestler, you know, I like to support my friends, especially when I see that they're doing good. I like to, you know, give them a little investment. You know, he wanted to kind of give me a break and I said no. I mean, there's no breaks when it comes to getting stuff from my friends. I don't expect like a pay cut or anything like that. I'll pay full price, you know, I'll rep it, I'll support it. So his links are down below. You know, and like I said, tell him the ring queen sent you. But this look in particular that I'm wearing is called Phenomenal, and here's a little close-up look. Are you living? Anyways, this was inspired by AJ Styles, and by now the Royal Rumble has come and gone, and if you watched this match between him and John Cena, it was one of the best matches I've ever seen. I think it was match of the night for the Royal Rumble, and I was inspired to do this makeup look. I had done it the weekend of the Royal Rumble, but I liked the look so much that I wanted to do it again and show you guys how I got this look. So if you want to see how I got all this put together and how I was inspired by AJ Styles' look and color scheme and help me achieve this look, please stay tuned. If you don't like me, ask me if I give a damn. Unless you're feeding me, fucking me, or financing me, I could give a fuck less about your opinion. So you could put all the negative comments you want down below, and I'll just use it to wipe my ass. So please stay tuned and let's get started with the tutorial. Okay guys, we're gonna start off with our Benefit Professional. I have like this travel one that I use for when I'm on the road wrestling. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of that and we're gonna put it all over our entire face. Like I said, I was inspired by the look because AJ Styles likes to wear blue. I mean, he's worn other colors, but because he's on SmackDown, he is kind of limited to wearing blue. So this is gonna be a lot of blue. It's gonna be a really vibrant look. So we're just gonna prime the whole entire face so that we can get started. And voila! Now, this is gonna be a full glam look. So I'm going to take my Smashbox Studio Skin 15-hour wear hydrating foundation. My damn Buddha Blender. This is a new one that I got. It's pretty cool looking. I kind of like this one a lot better than the other one that's kind of teardrop because it has a flat surface that makes it easier to like kind of, you know, beat your face with this stuff. You know, your foundation or your powders and stuff like that. And it still has a little teardrop top. You know, the little zipple of the nipple. So you can get into like the corners and stuff. like, you know, around the nose area, under the eyes and stuff. So we're just gonna take a little bit of this. I use four because I got a fat head, which means I got a fat face. And we're just gonna dot that everywhere and get to blending. And we're gonna take my big mirror that I have here that I use when I'm doing shows, because 99.9% of the time most locker rooms do not have mirrors, so it becomes increasingly difficult to do your makeup unless you're like kind of doing your makeup in the women's locker room. But not all locker rooms have like a women's bathroom, and if they do, it's usually being used by the fans, and you don't want to kind of be in there changing your gear in front of fans, so you kind of get forced to change into the locker room. And most locker rooms do not have, you know, a mirror, or you're limited to one mirror for an entire locker room of like maybe 15 guys. So sometimes it helps to just bring like a big enough mirror. And I got this one from the Body Shop, which has a regular and magnified side. So we're gonna just start blending everything in. Now, I'm not too fond of this one because it's a little too light for my skin tone, but if you got any suggestions as to which one is a better foundation to use that won't let me break out, because this one does not, you know, I don't break out using this foundation. I really am persnickety when it comes to foundation, so, you know, if you have any that are really, really good that won't make me break out, and please leave a comment down below and I will give it a try and do my first impressions and give you guys a review of how I feel that particular foundation works on my skin. Because as you can see now, boop, I'm freaking white. I'm a ghost. So we're going to continue blending this and then we'll be right back. Just adding one more pump so that I can kind of catch my under neck. Like, it's so important to like kind of blend down to the neck so that everything matches. So don't need that much. I mean, I would like to say that this foundation goes a long way, but it kind of doesn't. It takes me at least 4, with this one now 5 squirts. So again, if you know any good foundation that's full coverage, please comment below. Okay, guys? Let me just finish this up and I will be right back. Okay, I know I look a little silly because my face is washed out from the foundation that really doesn't match my skin tone. Maybe it does. Maybe I'm just really pale as hell. But I did my eyebrows off camera because you need a moment of silence and a holding of breath in order to do these properly. And I think I did a pretty good job. So now that we got that done, what we're going to do is we're going to take our Tarte Shape Tape Concealer and start concealing, or at least prepping our highlight. So like I said, don't need that much, just a couple of dollops, like the commercial of Dollop of Daisy. I just use a couple of dots. Don't need that much. See, I don't know if you can see the dots, little stripe on the nose, Cupid's bow, and the chin. And we're gonna start blending with
a booty blender. The blend of the booty.
If you ain't blending, you ain't booty. Okay, next I'm gonna finish the contours using my Smashbox Studio Skin Waterproof Concealer in medium. This is more closer to my skin tone than the actual, you know, studio foundation. I think I should get myself like a 2. Probably of this, because I'm really dark skinned, being that I'm Hispanic. I'm kind of pale for Puerto Rican, please don't judge me. I mean, there's still a little, you know, Spanish, Taino, and black in my veins. Just remember that. Do your history and culture, twines. So, with that being said, happy Black History Month too, because this will probably be released by Black History Month. If not, Then happy Black History Month, since I probably don't say it in any of my prior videos. We're gonna just kind of, not too much, it's a very subtle difference, but it's enough to kind of give me a guideline where my contours are gonna go. And it's not too dark where it's like, you know, I look like I have like dark brown stripes in front of my face. It's just enough subtlety, because when I put the powder on, it's definitely gonna change everything. So we just pop that in there real quick, and then we grab our beauty blender and just start blending. Okay, so now for contouring, I'm gonna grab my Shade and Light palette by Kat Von D, and I'm gonna go into this one, and I'm just gonna set all the under eye and all the light spots, and then I'm gonna probably go into my Hoola bronzer for all the other detailing. But I'll just go into this color right here and then just apply. Next, we go into our Hoola bronzer and then contour. Now we're gonna snatch the nose a little bit with the Hoola bronzer. Okay, now that we've got most of our face done, I'm gonna start with the eyes, and I prefer to do the highlighting last, because I feel like when you put the eyeshadow on, all the product fallout gets onto the highlight, and for me as a personal preference, it's a pain in the butt. You end up removing a lot of the highlight just trying to get rid of the product fallout. So I wait for that for last, because I do highlight the inner corners and my brow bone, and it kind of just, you know, while I'm there, I can just highlight everything else. So I usually do the highlighting for last. So I am going to prime my eyes and then come right back, because I don't want to waste your time. Okay, so we primed our eyes with our go-to Urban Decay's eyeshadow primer. And now we're going to go in, because this is a very colorful look. I'm not going to use like browns for transition colors. We're just going to go straight into the color, and we're going to use our Urban Decay Full Spectrum palette, and we're going to go right into this color called Metamorphosis, and we're going to use that to create the crease and provide the base for the crease, because it's going to be a bit of a cut creased look. I just don't use the tape. I'm a little scared to use that, so maybe when I do my Undertaker look, which is going to be called the Phenom, not to be mistaken with this look called the Phenomenal, because this one is based on AJ Styles, so there's a lot of blue. The Phenom is going to be a lot of gray, black, and a hint of purple, because of course the Undertaker is nothing without at least a shade of purple. But this look is all blue. And please try not to sing the song, because then it'll get stuck in my head too. So we're going to start with using that color, and we're just going to kind of use it to build it up. And it's a lot of pigment too, so just keep that in mind when you put that on. I have hooded eyes, but I still have a pretty big eyelid, so we're just gonna put it a little bit there. I don't know if you can see. There you go. See, it's these colors are really heavily pigmented, just so you know. I don't really tap on the brush when I add it. I mean, sometimes I do, but I like to hold on to as much of that pigment as I can. So we're gonna just build up all this blue. Okay, so to make this blue stand out a little bit more, we're gonna go into Blindsided, which is like this really nice, heavily teal, but bluish color, which is gorgeous. And when I did it initially with this look, it really made it pop. So we're gonna just take this and help create that definition in the crease. Okay, so now that we've got that in, we're gonna give it one more final bit of definition. And you're probably wondering why I don't mention the names of my brushes, because they're Eco Tools, and I can't afford more fees. I'm a broke broke asshole, and I'm just trying to build my brand from the ground up. I mean, there's not that many wrestlers that do makeup vlogs, and, you know, I'm trying to bridge that gap. I'm slowly but surely getting there, and until I can afford to get myself decent brushes, I use these really nice eco tools that have not failed me yet. But if you really want to know, I'm going to use my ultrafine eyeliner brush, and I'm going to create that crease so that when I add the, when I cut the crease and stuff like that, it'll look nice. So we're going to go into, I forgot to tell you, this color Minx, and then we're going to do a little line. Now that we've got the deep blue color in, we're going to blend it with brush. That's its name. Its name is Brush. It's an Urban Decay brush that came with the Alice Through the Looking Glass palette, but I call it Brush because so far it's done a lot of blending and packing, and it's just, to me, an all-around multi-purpose brush that has been my ride or die since day one. So, let's get to blending. Okay, now that we've got our crease in, we're gonna take our NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in, obviously, Milk, like a girl's go-to, and we're gonna just put that on the eyelid so that we have a good solid light colored base to put the whites and silvers on, and then also to provide the, you know, the corners, and it'll make the black pop out more, and, you know, the contrast between colors. So let's get started. Now for the other eye. Okay, so now that we've got that, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go into this really nice color called Bump. I wonder why it's called Bump. No, I'm kidding. but come on, people, it's called Bump. Anyway, we're gonna put this all over the eye, and then we'll put in the silver. I feel like it makes the silver stand out a little bit more when it has like a white background, and also this helps set the white cream kind of pencil that you put in and prevents creases when you go in with the silver color. So yeah, are you looking at me, coño? I know I look pretty. Okay, now that we got our white base, now we're gonna go in with our next color called Iced. And we're gonna put that all over the white. We're gonna go in a little bit with that mink color, it just to kind of like redefine the crease. Next, we're going to go into this color Platonic, which is like a grayish black, and we're going to put that on the corners and then a little bit to smoke out the eye, okay? So, let's get started. Okay, so to make the smoky eye underneath the blue pop a little bit more, we're going to go with Blindsided, and we're just going to kind of give it a little bit of pop of blue. Just remember, this color scheme is blue. Okay, now that we've got the eyes done, we are gonna go into our cheap Dollar Tree eyeliner and just start to line the eyes. Next, I'm gonna line my waterline with this NK Auto Eyeliner that I got from the dollar store, but not for nothing, for cheap stuff, this stuff works wonders. I mean, it's heavily pigmented and it comes up like a dream. So don't ever front on Dollar Tree stuff or 99 cent stuff, because sometimes you'd be surprised how well it works compared to high-end brands. And I'm not saying that I'm not allergic to high-end brands or allergic to cheap stuff. It's just, it depends on the formula and how my face reacts to it. I'm not really allergic to much, but you know.
No.
Some products make me break out and I look like a 15-year-old with a pizza face. So. No pizza face today! Let's get started. Now what I use is, and I actually learned this from watching one of Jeffree Star's makeup tutorials. This can save you a whole lot of time when you're doing this or when you're... It helps tug the skin without creating more additional wrinkles. So, if you ever feel the need to not want to ruin your youthful appearance and stuff, just grab a beauty blender, tug, and then, you know, put your stuff on. Like so. And again, this stuff is heavily pigmented, so this is gonna show up like BAM! I don't know if you can see it, but you know. We'll try it on this eye first so that you know you guys can see exactly what I'm talking about. So we're gonna put our mirror here and we're gonna line the waterline. I don't know if you can see it, but the blue has been applied, and I think it looks amazing. So now we're gonna, I have a cold, so I'm getting that like post-nasal drip that makes you feel like you sniffed an 8-bowl of Coke. Hence why I got the whole bump thing on their Urban Decay palette. All names. So now we're gonna use our Benefit Roller Lash, which is, I love this stuff. This one and Too Faced is Better Than Sex Mascara are like my two favorite mascaras. And they really go on well. And not for nothing, they come off pretty well too. So, you know, it's not like some of those that are cakey and they're like really hard and they kind of leave like a rough residue. And then, you know, when they dry up, they get like really flaky and nasty. No, not this stuff. It really makes my eyelashes feel really flexible and it gives me the extension on my lashes that I need. I don't like using false lashes because I don't like the thought of gluing something to my eye line. And, you know, the only thing I feel like that should go in your waterline or anywhere near your waterline is eyeliner. And that's it. So... we're just gonna put this stuff in and be right back. Okay, now that we have all that done, we're gonna put on our blush, which I'm using from my Sweet Peach Glow palette. We're gonna go into this really nice peachy color. But first, I wanna go into this brown and kind of. There you go. Kind of. Accentuate, I guess you could say, my contour. So, I'm gonna do that. Next, we're gonna go in with the peachy color. I've been in love with this blush for a very long time, ever since I got this, so I've been using it a lot. It's my go-to blush. So, we're just gonna put a little bit on a brush. It's a blush brush. I don't know where this one came from. But we're gonna put that right there on the apples of our cheeks. And I like the fact that it's iridescent and it kind of gives you like a little highlight. You see, like it kind of gives you that little peachy glow. So, I'm gonna put that on real quick. Okay, now for the highlighting. What I do is I start off with a base using my Benefit High Beam, which is complexion enhancer. It's also known as liquid highlighter. So we're gonna put that on the spots we want to highlight: tip of our nose, a little bit on the bridge, a couple of dots on the cheeks. Because this is the base where we're going to put the actual like highlight powder. This is just kind of a little base and then we set it with highlight powder. And I use two of them. What I do is I use the Sweet Peach Glow first and then I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit, which is this one. And I do this one last because what I do is I use it to highlight my brow bone and the inner corners of my eye. So let's just blend this liquid one first. Next, we're going to go into our Sweet Peach Glow. We're going to go into this really pretty shimmery color. And we're just going to place this right where we have our highlights. So. I don't know if you can see the shine. This computer has such a crappy, crappy.
So you pass out.
Camera.
You wake up.
Okay, now we're going to highlight with our Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit, but we're going to first highlight our brow bone.
Is there anything else I can do to make you feel better, or are you good?
And our inner corners. And I'm going to use this color Snow, since we've been using a lot of silvers, and we're going to just put that right there.
Sorry, I was working. Just tell me what you meant by... I mean not herself. I mean barely talking.
Now we're going to finish with this color called Sunray, and we're just gonna finish up the highlights, kind of make the highlight pop.
Happy birthday. Or not.
Oh, I wish y'all could see this. Ooh! Okay, now that everything is done, and this is full glam too, just so you know, because I did foundation. I don't normally do foundation unless I'm doing a show, and even when I do a show, sometimes I really don't use foundation. So, we're gonna finish with the lips, and I'm going to use a beautiful combination of Revlon's matte called Nude Attitude, and it's this really, really nice, like, matte nude color. I don't know if you can see it. There we go. That. It's a really nice flesh colored. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put on top of it Too Faced Clueless, which is a vibrant pinkish color, but it's got like little fleckles of glitter on it. I don't know if you can see that little shine right there is the shimmer. It's kind of like got built-in highlighters for the lips. So let's start lining the lips with Ulta's Dual Ended Lip Liner in Flesh, which is that color right there. I don't know if you can see where it says Flesh. Flesh! And let's begin. Now for the nude on top.
I need an answer. He deserves that. So can we just concentrate on me to get this done by exactly midnight, okay?
Sorry. And you think it's so boring, I replace it with dubstep. What's dubstep?
It says we need four people. Each one a match will adapt.
Now to set this whole entire look using my Urban Decay All Nighter makeup setting spray, which has been used by millions and millions of makeup beauty bloggers. This is how I usually do it, because you know, you gotta get a whole ring. I feel like my sister in the 80s or my brother in the 80s, back when like Aquanet was like the thing, and they would hold it out like this, and it was just like shh. Like sometimes my brother would use like so much hairspray that sometimes like me and my sister or my mom would just like kind of run up behind him and use like the residuals of what he wasn't using, just so that we wouldn't have all that wasted hairspray. Like, so yeah, pretty much the same principle here. Only 80s babies will understand this. Most people will be like, oh no, that's what you do when you do makeup. So, no. For us boo-boos, us people, it's the Aquanet distance. Because they used to go all around that dome piece. So. There we go.
This is what?
Flawless. Okay, I'm kidding, but you know. It's true. And just let that dry a bit. And this is the final look. This look I call the phenomenal. You know, AJ has those special gloves that say like P1 on it, which I think is pretty cool. But yeah, this was inspired by the Royal Rumble that just happened. Today's February 1st, which means that this was probably sometime the last weekend of January. I think 28th. Not too sure. I would have to look at my calendar. And I don't feel like doing that right now. Okay, look at yours. You got phones. So this is my AJ Styles inspired look. Please, please, please like, subscribe so you get the notifications every time I put up a new video. I have a show coming up. By the time you guys see this, the show will have done been passed because it's on February 4th for BWF. The One Man Gunslinger Trigger, who's my fiance, will be in action. I will most likely be in action. And hopefully we will be able to, you know, share the videos. My social media links are down below, so please follow me. Please, 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 please. And follow me on Twitter. Add me on Snapchat. And for all my Foot Fetish fans, exclusive foot content will be on my Snapchat. I at least take at least 2 or 3 pictures a day of my cute little toesies because they are adorable, and I do pay a lot of freaking money to make my toes look good. Do you know how much callus removal is? It is expensive. A dumpling. I make sure I got pretty feet. I respect myself because I like to make sure my feet are pretty for my fans. Anyways, like, subscribe, and this has been my phenomenal makeup tutorial look inspired by AJ Styles, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. Bye.